Let's talk about the community outrage about this year's Megatons. Oh boy, make sure you guys smash the living crap out of that subscribe button so you guys don't miss out on more awesome content. Hey, Kong's Cards, Gamer's Choice, discount code MCOL40 for those of you that want to buy singles for this set. So, this has been an absolutely hilarious train wreck out here as we have started to see set IDs, set numbers, and things like this, you know, rolling out here via this set. And I think one of my favorite things I have seen about this is, Robbie, you filthy Konami sponsored scum, how can you be so positive about the tins this year? That's not fair. You're not allowed to be. So first of all, do you see me out here? Konami sponsored? Do you? Did you see my tin opening? Did you? It was great, right? Yeah. You know why? Because it didn't happen. Because I'm not Konami sponsored. Alright? I hate to tell you this, but people are allowed to be happy. Alright? I think that's one of the funniest things that these tin openings have, you know, showed me about this community is how dare you allowed to be excited about something. The gadgets and the Light and Darkness Dragon QCRs, these cards are going to be extremely cheap, but I am allowed to be happy that some of my favorite cards received upgrades. And you know what? When you have positive influences in your life, dare I say, you're allowed. Oh no, is he going to say it? He's allowed to be happy. You're allowed to enjoy seeing rarity upgrades. You're allowed to see this. And hilariously enough to me, the community doesn't seem to realize that. So that was a pretty major takeaway from my comment section yesterday, was just reading the individual comments going, you filthy Konami sponsored scum, these tins are garbage. How could you do that? It's like, is people not allowed to like be happy? Are people not allowed? It's the meme of, it's like, oh, you know, you're not allowed to enjoy this. Stop having fun! It's like, you must suffer with all of us. We are all suffering out here. It's like, if you just genuinely don't enjoy something, then just don't buy it. Not everything is going to be for you, all right? Chill out, all right? I don't know what has happened with this community with certain people, but man, oh, man. It's that. So that was my personal takeaway from this. You're not allowed to be happy with this set. Alright, now, you know, sealed versus singles on this set. If you're opening this in mass, oh yeah, you're going to be fine. The stores out here that are opening this up and the people that are buying the singles out here, and you're looking at these, you know, extremely cheap QCR prices, like $5 for a QCR. You know, like, I don't have to open a case of these. And then on the other side of the faction over here, you have people that are looking at this set going, you know, I'm still going to open a 10. You know, $22 is fine. You know, I can get some of this. I also read some comments from people going, you know, I want to open up a couple of 10s just to have some bulk from this set laying around so I can find it later on, come back to it. And there's that. And then you have other people over here that are extremely happy about the rarity upgrades. And then you have the people that are really upset about the whole SP thing. People are upset that SP is $50 here on your price. Now, I need to kindly remind everybody out here that when you saw 400 cards set months ago, what did you think? What did you think? Did you think that the card was going to be $10? Did you go, man, this is great! Konami 400 card set. I'm going to be able to pull SP extremely easily out here, you know. You know, it's going to be great. And then the reality of the situation, you know, hits you like an isekai truck and now you're in another world and you're like, huh, well, shit, maybe I didn't think about this. That's a lot of the situation here is your average consumer, I don't think, really understands what a 400 card set meant. Because I remember months ago I was getting blasted with like, tins will be good this year, Robbie. It's the SP rebound. I mean, yeah, sure, SP's in the set. And I will give the tins one very good thing. The tins slash the value of SP in half. Alright, sure, it's not, you know, $100 anymore. Yeah, it is not, actually. You're at $50, and, you know, things have gotten a lot cheaper. And we also know Diabelstar in November is going to be about 50 cents. I'm sticking to that, by the way. You can sit here and be like, oh, you know, post-Bonanza. Once circulation happens with these reprint sets, you flush it down. Look at Rarity Collection 2's overall long-haul effect on the meta and how much it flushed the market on those cards. All right, I am telling you, all right, you need to be patient, all right? You do not have to have it now. You can enjoy these things later, all right? As a mean, Robbie, I want to play the best deck. You are going to have an extremely hard time post-Dominus Impulse and Fool Warso. You have other problems to deal with in this game in the future. So, according to the community, you are not allowed to be happy about this product providing you with rarity upgrades. Two, you are not allowed to be happy about SP going down in half price. I mean, I could see SP probably settling down about 40-50, but people seem to forget, you know, the pot situation that, you know, when we had a certain pot card get reprinted in the tins and it slashed down the value of that. That was incredibly useful. And then they reprinted it again. SP's reprint equity is going to hold up. They're going to reprint this in another set in the next couple of months. If you don't think SP's not getting another reprint sometime in the next year, what in the world? You're just doing it wrong. Konami now knows that they can reprint SP in a product and it will maintain a selling point of equity with this. So, all of that is said and done. Alright, I'm going to be honest with you. I figured that these tins weren't going to be great. Konami just refuses to acknowledge 2019 tins. Konami is like, oh, you know, like, you know, we can't put promos in the tins, you know. It's Konami doesn't want this community to look at a good product and go, huh, you know, Dark Ruler, Nibiru, the gods, everything about those tins was one of the best things ever. 2019 tins still hold up as one of the best products ever printed in Yu-Gi-Oh! History. But Konami, for some reason, just refuses to acknowledge that and wants to continue to shave down the value of things for the community. And, you know, I think this is Konami's way of going, secondary market, you're not allowed to make estimated value on product this year. All right, and that's the takeaway from this. Konami makes this product so ass that they're like, hey, they're punishing the secondary market. That's what it is. They don't want these stores to make an overabundance of money for opening up this set for profitability. They want things to be checked, and they want you to maintain, you know, some sort of check and balance out here on this sort of scale so that, you know, players can get things cheaply. I will give them some credit. This year's tins did a very good job at maintaining a good cheap price point. You know, the QCRs might not be the greatest in the world, but they're cheap. All right, minus Blue Eyes and minus Dark Magician Girl. But you know what? That's 48 other cards that are floating in, what, like $5 and below? I don't see an issue with that at all. And a lot of those QCRs are one-ups. All right, you don't need to rush out and do some crazy things with this. Cheap cards equals good. Don't have to open product to profit. All right, you're allowed to buy singles and do okay. To the people that did open up product, who knows, maybe you'll get an SP. Alright, I'm looking forward to the sheer amount of stories I'm about to hear from people that are about to go, holy crap, my case was broken. I got like 3 SPs, and you know what? I expect it to happen. I expect there to be some of the biggest, craziest clumping available out here, and people are going to lose their gosh darn minds. So, I think the tins are alright. I think you're allowed to be happy about the things you want to be happy with. And that's okay. You guys have a good rest of your day. And remember, QCR gadgets.
Patrons, thank you. Thank you so much for watching. Check out these other videos.